Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
My name is Alok Khandelwal and we are about to start this course on astrology. So before starting this course, I would like you to go through what we are going to learn in this course. So this course is about Vedic astrology, or we call it Jyotish in Hindi. We are going to learn basic techniques, the principles of astrology. Then we would be learning a lot of stuff regarding dashas, antar dashas, yogas, prediction techniques, how you can predict through Vedic astrology, what is the difference between Vedic astrology and Western astrology, what are the key component of Vedic astrology, and at the end of this course, you would be able to actually see the charts and would be able to predict in a scientific manner so that you can help people and actually you can play a vital role in their life. So we have always heard that the word is astrology, but the real word of this Shastra is Jyotish. So in a normal dialogue or in a day-to-day life, we call it astrology. But astrology is a science of reading the stars. Whereas Jyotish has an altogether different meaning. When you learn this science as Jyotish, the entire meaning of your learning will be changed. So when I say the word Jyotish in Sanskrit, it is the second name of Lord Sun. So as you all know, sun is responsible for life on this planet. If there is no sun, there is no life. We are a human, we are called a human being, we are a living being only because of Lord Sun. And Jyotish is the name of the Lord Sun. Now sun, in our Vedic culture, we say sun is Atma Sarup. It is the indicator of soul. Now when I say Jyotish, it is basically Jyoti plus Ish. So Jyoti, the word Jyoti means in English is light, and Ish is Ishwar. Ishwar is God. So when I am able to see light in the other person, now what is light? So as you all aware, we say that soul is in us in a light format. It is just like Jyoti Swarup. So in my body, if there is a soul, it is just like a light. So when I see that light in some other person, when I see that light in myself, the study of that light is called Jyotish. Now you would be able to understand how different it is from the word astrology. Astrology is just the science of reading stars. But when I am saying Jyotish, it is different. I am not only reading the stars, but we are able to make that person or ourselves much aware into spiritual upliftment also. So this is not only the science of prediction, or maybe you can predict to somebody, you can tell somebody about their fortune. It is basically a science of spirituality. Because sun is the karka for spirituality. It is the karka for our soul. So Jyotish is a vidya or a education or a science to connect me to my soul. Now, the moment I said this, the entire meaning is different. So when I am doing Jyotish, basically I am connecting to my soul. When you are doing Jyotish, you are connecting to your soul, and you are, as a Jyotishi, or in a normal jargon, as an astrologer, you are able to connect to other souls also. The moment you connect to other souls, it is a one-to-one matter. Then you can actually help people. You can touch their lives. Now, as I said, the sun, the name of the sun is Jyotish. So we as an astrologer or Jyotishi is basically doing the job of Lord Sun. So when I look at any chart, I become sun. When you will look at any chart, you will become sun. Now, other than life, what is the other qualities of sun? So sun gives the vision, and only through vision basically we can see the future. So So when you learn Jyotish, you become more closer to Lord Sun. And in our Vedic culture, we say Sun is a significator of Dharma. It is a significator of my Dharma. Dharma means what I am supposed to do as a human being. That is Dharma. So when I define this science as Jyotish and the significator is Sun, I think we should follow some code of conduct so that we can be more near to Lord Sun, we can be more near to our soul, and then we can evolve as a good human being, and we can help others also to evolve as a good human being. So before starting this course, since when you learn this course, you will be becoming an astrologer or a Jyotishi, I would actually like to tell you something which you need to do or you should do. Because this is not a science which is basically based on techniques. This is, as I said earlier, this is a science of spirituality. So it is good if we follow some conduct. So the normal word which you normally heard is astrologer. It is again an English word which has a limited meaning. But when I say Jyotishi, you are representing Sun. And then the other word for this in our Shastras is Devagya. Now Dev is called God. But in Sanskrit, the word Dev is, the meaning of the Dev is knowledge. So Devagya or a Jyotishi or an astrologer is somebody who is near to Dev. So as I said, Dev can have two meanings. One is Dev as Devata or God. Second, Dev is knowledge or light. So when you become an astrologer or a Jyotishi, basically you are supposed to be somebody who is near to light, who is near to Dev. Now knowledge is the purest. So when you are near to knowledge, you need to maintain some code of conduct. And it is advisable to maintain that code of conduct. Although you can still learn astrology or Jyotish without maintaining that code of conduct. But I am telling you what Rishi Parashara has told us to do. And in my life also, I personally experienced that. When I maintain that, I become a wonderful Jyotishi. And if I am actually, when I was not following that, then it was a little difficult for me to learn this science. Because this is so heavy, this is so precious and endless that you need to follow some code of conduct to digest this knowledge. That's why it is said that this knowledge you cannot attain without a teacher or a guru. Because this has to be transferred to you by a guru or a teacher. Now, what are these code of conduct? Now the first code of conduct which you should do, I am emphasizing on the word should, that when you are trying to learn this science, when you become an astrologer or a Jyotishi, you should follow a sattvic life. That is like, first you should be, if it is good if you are a vegetarian, because vegetarian food will help you to digest this knowledge, because your mana is lighter when you eat vegetarian. Your mind is a little calmer when you eat vegetarian. So preferably, if possible, I know it is difficult for some people across the world, it is difficult for people to eat only vegetarian, but you can still try. And then when you can see the change, I should not tell you then. So when you yourself see the change that, okay, by following the vegetarian diet, then you will yourself follow. So first, it is good if you eat light food or a vegetarian food, because non-vegetarian food takes a lot of time to get out of our system, and then it increases our tamas level. Tamas is like the heart shape or the negative qualities in our manas. And vegetarian food increases our sattva level. So when you are sattvic, you are more happier. When you are sattvic, when you are more close to the God. So this is one thing. So I will conclude it like this, that your food is very important if you want to become a Jyotishi. Very important that you eat balanced food, eat on time, and a sattvic food. So when I say sattva, it is good that if you follow some practices. It doesn't mean that you should do some Hindu mantra, but it is good in whatsoever religion you are. If you're doing some sort of sadhana or some sort of prayer of your own religion, then it is good for you to learn Jyotish. And the last one, which is very important. Since I have said earlier that Lord Sun is named as Jyotish, and the mantra for Lord Sun is Gayatri mantra. So it is said in our Shastras that Brahma, who is the creator of this universe, when they created us, they put Gayatri mantra in our soul, and that is the reason we are here on this earth. So Gayatri mantra is something which is related with our soul. And Surya or Sun is the significator of soul. So when you do Gayatri mantra, the power in you, your soul power, or in Jyotishi language I will say, your sun will improve. When your sun will improve, you would be able to predict better. Because ultimately you are learning this science to predict. You are learning this science to help yourself and you help others. So I always advise people to do Gayatri Japam. So Gayatri Japam, the mantra, you can get into the notes. We will give you the mantra in the notes. You can actually go to YouTube and then listen to the mantra, and then when you start chanting it properly, then you start chanting it. It is always advisable to take the Diksha for the Gayatri mantra, because it is called Brahma Upadesh. Brahma Upadesh is the Upadesh. Upadesh is narrative given by Brahma, who is the creator. So when it is Brahma Upadesh, it should be given by a guru or a Brahman. So it is good if you take a proper Diksha of Gayatri mantra, so that you can be initiated into Gayatri mantra, and then you start learning Jyotish. But you are not required to restrict yourself up to that Diksha or start chanting Gayatri mantra. You can still learn Jyotish. But whatever I am telling you, it is for the betterment, that you would be able to digest this knowledge in a much better way, and you can become a good Jyotish. So three things I have told you, which is into the code of conduct. First, maintain a sattvic life. Take good food, preferably vegetarian food. And third is Gayatri mantra. I will not say it is the code of conduct, but the last thing which I want to say is, maintain a life which is non-violent. Try not to disturb others by your karmas, and follow a religious life if possible, in whatsoever religion you are. These four things if you do, over a period of time, you will become a wonderful astrologer. You will become a good astrologer. Although we are just starting this course, and I know I have said something which can be a burdensome thing for somebody, but don't worry. If you don't do this also, you start learning Jyotish, the Lord Sun himself will give you that inspiration that you will start doing something of that sort. Because I have seen during my career as an astrologer for last 20 years, I have seen that when people start learning Jyotish, there are sudden changes in their life which comes. They automatically go to the vegetarian diet, they will start chanting mantras, they will do good to the others, they will do seva. That happens automatically. Because this is such a wonderful subject, this is such a captivating subject, that you will fall in love with this subject. And when you start learning and getting deeper into this, there are changes in your manas, there are changes in your mind, there are changes on the soul level, there are changes which makes you a good human being. So don't bother. If you are not ready to start all this right now, trust me, you will be doing after some time. And then that day you will remember this first lecture of this course. So this is the preface which I wanted to give you about this course. Now I will take you further into different lectures. I will try to make videos which are easy to understand. I would like my technical team to support me, so that we can present these videos into a graphical format also, wherever it is necessary. And I would be using very simple language which you can understand anywhere, which I will be using some technical words. I will try to give you the meaning of that technical word. So don't bother if you know nothing about Jyotish. Then also you would be able to learn this science. And in my experience, it has come, it is good if you know nothing about this course, about this science. Because if you are a blank page, I can write it easily. Because this science is so big. And various people, different people have different concepts, different views. So it is always good to learn it into a structure format. So for both of the people who knows Jyotish or who doesn't know anything about Jyotish, this course will be up to the mark as per your expectation. Don't worry about that. So now we will start this course, and I will wish you luck, all of you who are joining this course, and I will try my best to teach you. Just be there, have patience, you will become a wonderful Jyotish. Thank you.